getting ready to go green flag racing. Man, this is going to be a good one. Rhett Carter alongside of Dalton Cook as the field rolls down the back straightaway. 50 laps straight ahead. $5,000 the payday off of turn four. Carter versus Cook. And the 44 is going to gain the advantage. Oh, Dalton Cook right up against the wall. Carter will fight him off. They go three, four wide off of turn two. It's going to be Joe Brown and Will Harrington battling for that third spot. And now Harrington will make the crossover, the double zero of Will Harrington. Way down low, Joseph Brown in the 92, able to hold him off for a second, but the 44 of Rhett Carter has set sail, and now Brown right back at Harrington. Harrington's going to clip the wall, and Harrington will return the favor off of turn two. Will Harrington, Joe Brown, battling for the third spot. And once again, both drivers stay in the throttle, and Will Harrington will regain third. Such action for the third spot. You can't take your eyes off of it. But Rhett Carter has built up about a 10, maybe 12 car length lead. And I'll reset the field as they come down the front straightaway. Rhett Carter, your leader in the 44. Dalton Cook second in the one. Will Harrington third, the black double zero. Joe Brown fourth, the 92. And points leader J.R. Mosley rounds out the top five as the Southern Thunder Late Models will settle in to green flag action. Race leader has caught the tail end of the field. Caleb Gay is going to go down a lap. Dispinetti is going to go down a lap. David Poole, the next in line, as Rhett Carter is slicing and dicing through this field. Carter, about a lap away from disposing of about three good cars, as David Poole trying to get out of the way. Now Dalton Cook is able to get by. Will Harrington making a big gain in that exchange. And now Dalton Cook really got to watch, as the double zero of Harrington really put the pressure on. Caleb Gay in the three car is going to come into the infield pits. Elijah Gonzalez had slowed. Now David Poole will go to the upper pits. As the field cycles through some lap traffic, Dalton Cook riding in second has got to be oh so careful. Will Harrington ready to pounce as Elijah Gonzalez is just ahead of the one and the double zero. Here comes Joseph Brown. Joseph Brown's going to slip under the double zero. And these guys continue to battle. Brown and Harrington been trading punches all race long. And Joseph Brown has the spot for the moment. As the second, oh, Will Harrington off the pace. And Mosley with some heavy right side sheet metal damage. Not sure what happened, but Will Harrington got out of the gas and they stacked up behind him. Elijah Gonzalez, the 25 car, he is fighting desperately to keep from going a lap down. And Gonzalez finding some speed in the 25. Right now, Tristan Seeley in the 35 in danger of going down a lap. And Keith Edge, the 18, also in danger, as Will Harrington will exit the racetrack. Rhett Carter is absolutely dominating in this Southern Thunder late model feature. Now Cook looks to the inside of Gonzalez. The 25 once again is going to fight back as J.R. Mosley off the pace. The 27 of J.R. Mosley will come to a rest as smoke or make that radiator fluid erupting out of the top of the car and absolutely overheating issues with the 27. And what you see right there, guys, that's the radiator overflow that car's. And you can see they are working frantically trying to keep JR in this race. They're going to pull the hood, get a closer look at that overheating issue. They're going to take that thing back to the hauler. And what you see now, guys, this is called a Delaware restart. The leader will fire, and everybody stacks up too deep behind them. And the big gainer in that exchange is going to be the 92 of Joseph Brown. And Joseph Brown is going after our leader. Oh, Keith Edge! And the 51 of Chad Tootin. And now Edge will lose the handle. Gonzalez barely getting by. Now Gonzalez into the wall, hard under the flag stand. Oh, all kinds of action. The 35 of Seeley. Something that failed on the race car. Meanwhile, back on the track, Rhett Carter about. To go back green flag racing. And right now, Joseph Brown, the young man in the 92 car, he'll be shown in second. Halfway signal this time by. Halfway this time by. As this field has been cut to just a skeleton from what we started with, it's going to be Rhett Carter, your leader. Joseph Brown appears to be tracking him down. He rides in second. Dalton Cook third. Chad Tootin fourth. Tristan Seeley, a late arrival, being shown in the fourth spot. And how about Caleb Gay also? A late arrival. And these guys right now are going to get a top five finish, man. That's why it's so important to stay in the game. And that big, big lead that Rhett Carter had has now been whittled down to about a car length as Joseph Brown will pull right up on the rear bumper. Joseph Brown stalking the 44. It'll be Carter who has led every lap that sliced and diced his way through traffic. And now the Columbus flash of Joseph Brown taking a look to the inside. So far, Carter has been able to turn him back. At this point, you gotta figure those tires are starting to go away as Carter has set a blistering pace. Joseph Brown, the young man that had so much success in the sportsman division, stepped up to late models. He's already scored a win this year. Always a top contender. And Joseph Brown looking to put his name on that $5,000 check. But Rhett Carter continues to lead. A very fast race car Carter has. Continues to erase these laps as Caleb Gay slowly moving down the backstretch. I'm not sure that Caleb Gay is going to make it. Now he'll be able to make that left turn into the pits. But the battle up front, not over yet. Rhett Carter with a little bit of breathing room. Joseph Brown, who started this race third, he had a good qualifying run, always shows up with a fast race car. And just a few laps ago, Joe Brown really keeping the pressure on Carter. Carter has found a little bit of breathing room. We're past the halfway point, not a whole lot of time to get it done. As Carter, Brown, Cook, Tootin, and Seeley are being shown as your top five. Coming off of turn number four, he's looking to go wire to wire, the 44 of Rhett Carter. He unloaded with a fast race car. He bested a stout field of Southern Thunder late models. And your winner in car 44 will be Rhett Carter in the Southern Thunder late model portion of the Georgia Showdown. And we're going to go down and have a word with our race leader. I'm joined down here on the front straightaway by the winner of our Southern Thunder late model portion of the Georgia Showdown. Rhett, I gotta say, man, last night you come out of the box. You were real fast in qualifying. You backed it up here tonight, man. Tell us about your win.
Oh, we're just glad to get it. We've had so much misfortune over here at Cochran as far as break-in and just made the wrong call a few times. Just glad to get one of these over here. Really appreciate all the fans. This place here packs them out, and just everything we've done for the Armed Forces, that was just killer, and it's just awesome. Just feel good about it. Mike at Wildcat, he builds us a super strong motor that helps us do this, and Tracy Harris, can't say enough about what he does for us. That's the Mac 44 and his whole family, and I'm actually part of his family, and it's just a blessing that we get to do this. Just like you said earlier, you know, a lot of people don't get to do the things we do, like hang out with their families and go on vacation, which is a vacation for us. But we're fortunate, you know, to be where we're at, be right here in Cochran tonight. Everybody here is fortunate to be here, and we just appreciate everything.
Rhett, that is so well said, man. You have run with the Southern Thunder late models for a long time. You've had some success in this series. This is one of those series, man, that is so tight. There is a different winner all the time. What's it like coming out race after race against this kind of competition?
Well, you just know you got to be up on your game because there's going to be guys like Dalton Cook, Joseph, Will. Those guys are going to bring it every night, so you got to be ready. If you want to run up front, you're going to have to mash the gas. Like tonight, I wasn't real wild about running wide open around here for 40 laps. I wish it had been a little bit slower and a little bit. But, I mean, it's fun, and it's cool for the fans, but it's hard on old man.
I hear you. Rhett, we congratulate you, man. A nice job. Give it up once again for your winner in the Southern Thunder late models, and he's taking home the big payday. I'm going to go back and see if I can get a word. Dalton, while you're here, we'll stop and talk with you. Dalton, congratulations, man. A big smile on your face. And I know that you are just 3 points back of J.R. Mosley. Unfortunately, J.R. having some problems with overheating. And naturally, you've taken over the points lead. What does this mean, man? In this competitive of a series, what does this mean?
Well, I say I'm pretty excited about the whole event tonight. J.R. Mosley's a heck of a competitor. They got a first-class group over there. It's unfortunate they had some issues tonight, but I know they're going to be tough to finish out the series with. But other than that, you know, Rhett Carter's a hell of a wheel, man. He's been on a roll now. He ought to be on the points lead, I believe, on that. And Joseph Brown back there, I mean, he first year in late models, and he's wearing everybody out as far as I can see. So he's an awesome guy himself. I like all the racers out here. We have a good time. Damn, that's a long race right there. I'm about out of breath on it. But other than that, I want to thank my sponsors. Bobby Thomas got me a heck of a motor in that thing, and Hunter's Pub and Steakhouse got fine steaks. Y'all to stop by. Parker's Towing helped me from the beginning there. You know, my business, you know, doing the wraps. I appreciate everybody that gives me their business. I surely appreciate it. Otherwise, I wouldn't be out here. James Stevens of Penske Racing Shocks. He's had me going pretty good, because I tell you, I ain't got a clue about setting these things up, but they get me going in the right direction. I don't know. I think I'm out of breath now, but I had fun doing my first interview. I appreciate it, Pastor.
Hey, congratulations. Dalton Cook with a top three finish. Let me get back here real quick. Joe Brown, congratulations on a great finish, man. You have had so much success here at Cochran in a sportsman car. You've won over here. And tonight, man, you were ever so, so close, man. Tell us about your run.
Yeah, we had a really good car. The heat race was kind of, you know, I felt like if we could have won it, we would have had a better shot. But all in all, good night, run good, didn't tear up nothing, and congrats to Rhett. He's probably the best race car around here right now. He's really good and good driver. Thanks, everybody, for coming out. I appreciate it. Just like to thank all my sponsors. Five-star Hyundai, Mr. Mike Hurd. He does a lot for me and does a lot for all the racing around here. My dad, my girlfriend. We stuck it out one more weekend together, so we're going to try it again next week.
Joe, congratulations on a great month. Give it up for Joe Brown, your runner-up. All right, I'm going to send it back up top to the voice of the Southern All-Star Super Late Bottles, Mr. Dwayne Keith.